I said I'm done with politics. I'm done with DC. But the fact of the matter is, DC won't be done with me. All right. Joe Biden is supposedly the most popular presidential candidate in American history. He had more votes than anybody, more than Trump, more than even Obama, even though Obama beat him in the primary in 2008. But anyway, that's the narrative we're going with here. So popular, he had an inauguration with 30,000, at least 30,000 National Guard servicemen and women. They had a big parade, but nobody on the sidewalk. I mean, what's the point of having a big parade if no one's there? Anyway, he passed a bunch of executive orders, so I decided I want to comment on some of it. One, the reversal of the transgender policy as far as the military. So it looks like it's going to be a little bit easier for them, for the transgender people, to be able to really get into the military. They won't have as many obstacles. I do wonder about, you know, financially, if somebody is requiring drugs for their transition, how is that going to work if they're in the military? I mean, the fact of the matter is, when you're in the military, you're giving up a lot of rights, a lot of freedoms, and there's a lot of restrictions in place. It has to be because it's a military and the whole situation. But anyway, that's one of the things he did. He also put a freeze on some of the policy changes that Trump put in place in his final days. He also wanted to sever ties in contracts with private prisons, which, you know, I'm okay with. I support that, especially if they have a plan to actually decrease the amount of people they're going to be incarcerating to begin with. He also implemented, he reversed a travel ban. So people coming from 7 Muslim countries, they'll be able to get visas in about 45 days or so. Trump put a ban on that. That's okay as long as they have a plan to actually vet people coming into this country. Because this border security and all that stuff doesn't seem to be something that's taken seriously. Speaking of which, Biden signed an executive order to remove, to take away some funding from the border wall, which is interesting. When it comes to these DC politicians, they don't mind using taxpayer money to protect them, you know, to put up walls and fences and everything to protect them. You know, they'll spare no expense when it comes to the taxpayers' money. But, you know, when it comes to like the border security, it's like, we don't really need that. Climate change, that's a big thing with them. He had one executive order dealing with the climate crisis. Yeah, okay, crisis. You want to know what's a crisis? The biggest surge in the property rate in 50 years, okay, according to the economists. With the University of Notre Dame and the University of Chicago, when it comes to the amount of people poor, the rate skyrocketed. Okay, we're talking 8 million people now. It's probably got a lot more than 8 million people who are poor in America. But they said 8 million is an increase of 5.4 percentage points, to an increase of 2.4 million people in just one year, last year. It depends on how you define what it means to be poor. But we can get into all that later on in some other video. But hey, the climate crisis, Biden put in an executive order ending the Keystone XL pipeline. And I think 1,200 mile pipeline bringing crude oil from Canada to the US. A lot of people are angry about that. You can't be surprised if you listen to Joe Biden during the second debate. He basically said, yeah, we're looking at the end of oil, end of all this. And I had a discussion with somebody at work about this, a whole situation of transitioning from oil to electric cars and all this other stuff. Thing is, it takes a while to build up the infrastructure. And realistically, when we look at an economic downturn, the trends in this country, or as far as automation and machines being able to do the work of 1,000 men. Yeah, how are people going to be able to afford these electric cars, all this new technology? I mean, what's going to happen with all these people who are driving around and going to work, going day to day? They're going paycheck to paycheck. I don't know. We'll see. I'm not against alternative fuels as long as it's a viable replacement for oil. And because you gotta look at, okay, look at this pipeline. Look at all the people who are gonna lose their jobs. Not only just the people working on the pipeline, all the people working in the factories that supply the parts for these pipelines, the parts, the tools, the transportation to get things, all this stuff, and all the other businesses that benefited from all the business of this pipeline. There's going to be a big ripple effect. All these small businesses that supply things to them. I don't care if it's food. I don't care if it's restaurants. It's just one big ripple effect. But you know, when you spend decades and decades in Washington D.C. getting your funds from D.C. and you don't really have to start your own business other than his side business with Biden Hunter. But anyway, you don't really care about this type of stuff. But oh well. I mean, those are some of his executive orders. He had many, many, many executive orders. I can't even remember all of them. But all this seems to be a lot of hot air. You know, none of this stuff. He's not really dealing with the biggest issue, the whole economic situation. And there's reports of, oh, he's inheriting a big economic problem. Well, the reason why we have a big economic problem is because idiot governors thought it would be a good idea to shut everything down over this virus situation. That reminds me, he had one executive order requiring people to wear masks on the federal property. Here's the thing about these masks. I've been wearing a respirator since April. A respirator with a P100 filter. Filters out 99.9% of particles or more. Now, it doesn't filter out the virus, but it filters out the particles in which the virus travels in, right? The organic vapors. At least it has some type of ratings. It was highly effective because I was in a situation where I was surrounded by people who had COVID-19 and I did not test positive. So I know it works. Most people walking around in cloth masks that are made out of the same material that their underwear is made out of. Let's be honest here. I don't know how effective that is. I really don't. Maybe it reduces the amount of virus that people get when they transmit it from one person to another. I don't know. I hope it is effective, but hoping doesn't make it a fact. anyway, this is what's going on in this country, and the bottom line is we're on our own. One of the executive orders was that Biden increased, SNAP by 15% or food assistance by 15%, which is cool and all, but we're on our own, man. The government, they're not going to be able to help us. A lot of people in D.C. don't care. Right now, they're working on an impeachment trial. They're trying to impeach a president who's not even in office. And Rand Paul was talking about how this is unconstitutional, and 45 other Republican senators agreed with him. Romney did not. Which I don't know why Romney is there. I don't know what's going on with Utah sending Romney to the U.S. Senate. Then again, I'm here in Kentucky, and we sent Mitch McConnell to the Senate. D.C. is not coming to help us. My next goals will be communication. Even though I'm not working with people, I want to at least be able to hand somebody a radio if there's a crisis. Hand somebody a radio, be able to communicate with neighbors or whatever in case something goes down. That's all going to be one of my priorities. I'm going to speak with some neighbors to really encourage people to start prepping for emergencies. It's one of the things I want to do. You know, people, they notice the gun videos, but you know, they don't really talk about the food preparation videos or the water and stuff like that. I hope people are preparing, but wish me luck on all that. I want to make some changes with my EDC. I'm going to get some new Kydex holsters. Time to get some new holsters. I'm going to try a different company. I shouldn't have to wait 8 weeks, 8 to 10 weeks to get a holster. That's ridiculous. If you have any suggestions, let me know. I'm looking at a Vetter right now. I think that's one of the companies I'm looking at right now. I'm going to get a new belt as well. So anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.